So training is awesome, but what does training actually do? And what are our major goals? Well, one of our major goals for most people is to increase muscle hypertrophy. Well, a lot of people don't know is there's different types of muscle hypertrophy, and today we're gonna hint on that. The first type of hypertrophy that we're gonna talk about is sarcoplasm or sarcoplasmic hypertrophy. What does all that fancy mumbo jumbo mean? Sarcoplasm is the fluid around the muscle cells. Now, that fluid changes in size. The sarcoplasmic cell changes in size based on one thing mostly, and that's lactic acid tolerance. So sarcoplasmic hypertrophy comes from higher volume. I call sarcoplasmic hypertrophy bodybuilding hypertrophy, by meaning that you're gonna be doing sets of 10, 12, upwards of 45 seconds, possibly a minute. But it's that deep lactic acid burn type sets and reps that cause sarcoplasmic hypertrophy and that bodybuilders tend to try to go to as much as possible. The next type of hypertrophy would I be considered powerlifting hypertrophy or very strength-oriented sport hypertrophy, which is myofibroactin-myosin hypertrophy. That's where the actual proteins in the muscle are actually thicker and stronger. So myofibril hypertrophy, although I think is much, much more difficult to sustain, it also seems to have much more of a permanent effect. For instance, if you look at a guy like Bill Kazmaier, he's nearly 70 years old and still looks like he lifts weights. He still looks like he trains his butt off. The point is that bodybuilders tend to, when they come off a competition, they shrink, they lose 50, 60 pounds. Myofibril hypertrophy seems to last a little bit longer and seems to have a more permanent change on the body. And over time, myofibril hypertrophy will affect sarcoplasmic hypertrophy. And that's why you see a lot of the greats like Dorian Yates and Ronnie Coleman first started off as powerlifters and strength athletes and then converted over into bodybuilding. So you have to have both, but sarcoplasmic hypertrophy is more of the muscle pump and myofibril hypertrophy is more of the muscle actually changing in its protein makeup. So let's go over what these different types of hypertrophy types are. Well, in sarcoplasmic hypertrophy, in my opinion, it's more slow tempoed stuff like 3-3 and 5-5 tempos. If you don't know what those are, go watch our Wenning Strength tempo video. Time under tension, meaning that a lot of times that these sets, if you want maximal sarcoplasmic hypertrophy, they need to be somewhere between the range of about 35 seconds to 1 minute. That's how long the set should take to increase maximal sarcoplasmic hypertrophy. The next thing is that sarcoplasmic hypertrophy tends to be used, at least in our style programs, with isolated movements, i.e. leg curls, bicep curls, tricep extensions. It doesn't mean that you can't have sarcoplasm and myofibril hypertrophy in core movements such as squatting and deadlifting. I just think that if you separate this in your mind, it'll give you a better idea of what these are and how they work. But squats will create sarcoplasmic hypertrophy as well as straining movements. Myofibril hypertrophy is high force. So if you want to change the fibrils of the muscle, you really have to strain your balls off. So max effort method, it really works with myofibril hypertrophy. Straining, so we have to strain really, really hard, squatting, deadlifting, core movements. Obviously, straining hard on a bicep curl is not gonna be nearly as effective for myofibril hypertrophy as doing something insanely hard for the entire body, such as a squat, a deadlift, etc. Now, squats and deadlifts and all that, like what we talked about, they will create all different types of hypertrophy. These are not all primarily like singular, but I think if you look at it in these different perspectives, you're gonna find that you're gonna see why bodybuilders don't necessarily always use squats and deadlifts to create that type of hypertrophy. They use mostly isolated movements. So we need both hypertrophy to get better at sport, better at bodybuilding, better at anything. But there are some slightly different training modalities that we need for these two different things to shine. Now, which one's more important for you? You need to go on our Patreon channel and find out, but I will give you a tip. The tip is which one do you need the most and what are your genetics? So in the end of the day, sarcoplasmic hypertrophy and myofibril hypertrophy are gonna be limited not only to your training and diet and sleep, they're also gonna be limited to your genetics. So what you have to do is find out what your genetics are and what your sport needs are, and then design a program based on these particular different modes and uses of training. If you're unfamiliar with what max effort work is, dynamic work is, which changes what type of hypertrophy, please go on more in-depth view of what you can do to change this type of training.